There's no doubt that of all our empirical conquests, the one country that's probably had the greatest impact on our food culture is India.
Memsahib's returning home from the Raj brought back with them a love of Indian cuisine and ingredients, which they duly incorporated into a host of Anglo-Indian hybrid dishes. But with the arrival of many Indian and Pakistani immigrants in the 50s, 60s and 70s, our love of all things Indian was to develop even further.
Asif Ali is the third generation of his family to run the Sheesh Mahal, a landmark Indian restaurant in the west end of Glasgow.
Because Britain went out and explored the known world and developed an empire, it helped my family to come into Britain and make a life for themselves. And the only thing they could do was to cook.
So you've come to Glasgow, have you? Pretty grim, isn't it?
Well, he's not going to get a job for Glasgow Tourist Board, is he? But the cold, wet, windy streets of Scotland's second city were remarkably receptive to these new flavours from overseas. And the recipes concocted by Asif's dad, Ali, proved a big hit.
The amazing thing was that the Glaswegians took curry like ducks to water. Because the weather is so dark and rainy, the people are the exact opposite. They're warm and generous. So when they came in and tasted it, they were addicted. They loved it and we've never looked back since.
But back in 1971, when a customer didn't like what he was served up, his dad's quick thinking led to a curry that has become synonymous with the success of Indo-British cuisine across the country.
Yep, chicken tikka masala has numerous reported claims of origin. But as far as Asif's concerned, it was born in Glasgow.
My father tells me it was a typical Glaswegian night. It was pouring down outside, it was dark, and a bus driver came off duty and he had a terrible day, so sat down and ordered a chicken curry. Chicken curry came, he sent it back to the waiter. He says, it's dry and I want something not as dry. So at that time, Dad had an ulcer and he was enjoying a plate of tomato soup. So Dad says, why don't you put some tomato soup into the curry and put some spices and that'll give him a wee bit different flavour. So the chef did that and sent it back to the table and he absolutely loved it. And he came back the next day and the day after and he brought his friends and eventually we decided we will put it on the menu.
And with that, an Indian food legend was born.
Its success saw Ali refine the recipe, ditching the soup for fresh tomatoes, cream and a cacophony of spices. These days, it's thought that one in every seven curries ordered is a chicken tikka masala. In many people's eyes, it's now our national dish, but it's not stopped it going abroad, even to India.
India is growing so fast, there's so many tourists coming to Britain, and they want to take away the taste of Britain with them. So along with all the other British things, they take away the love of chicken tikka masala because it's unique to Britain.
Usually, I'm the guinea pig at some point. Usually, I come in here and they just say, there you go, try that, see how that goes. But it's one of my favourite dishes, Indian, and I love haggis as well.
I think there's many think that this is our home cooking now. You know, it's not the porridge anymore. it's a chicken tikka masala, I think. It's taken over from it for breakfast, lunch and dinner.
Well, I always think that curries are Scottish.
Once you start accepting different food, then it's not a huge leap to start accepting people. And when you start accepting people, you become more tolerant and more open as a society and a much richer society. We're at the dawn of the second British Empire. The first empire went out and conquered through might. The second British Empire is going out and conquering by cuisine.